SeeShell makes desktop and web automation fast to create and easy to maintain. Let's see how it works. The task I want to automate this to open Chrome, load a web page, and print it to a PDF. I start by clicking the record icon. Now, the image recording wizard appears. First, I need to do a double click on the Chrome icon. I resize the screenshot area accordingly and select double click. Then I click add. The next step is to enter the website address. For this, I use the click and type commands, so it first finds the image and then sends the text and special key for enter. This loads the website. In the next step, I use a second click and type command to open the Chrome print dialog with the Ctrl and P shortcut. And then, as the last steps, I click the print button, fill in a file name, and press enter. The page is printed as PDF and appears on the desktop. I finished recording and will save the macro. Now I close Chrome and I delete the file I just printed so I can run a test. To start the macro, I double click it in the sidebar. The macro runs, open Chrome, loads the website, and prints it. All done. The replay worked fine. Now let me show you how easy macro maintenance is. Right-click the macro, select Edit, and the macro opens up in an editor. Let's assume I want to make sure that only the first page gets printed by adding 1 here. To do so, I duplicate the line, change the command to click and type. I click the image, and then, in the Replace box, select Take Screenshot and grab a new screenshot. I also give it a new name and press OK. And, as the last edit, I give the printed PDF a new name. All done, the macro has been updated. Let's play the new sequence. All done, the replay of the updated macro worked fine. This was a quick look at SeeShell's image-driven automation.